So here we are. We'll hook this one up first because it's up here. So I have the white wire from the neck pickup attached to the center pole of this control. Now, something that kind of impressed me about these pickups is the wires are pre-tinned, which is to say they already have some solder infused in them. And so connecting them is a lot easier than connecting just regular bare wire. So the wire is behaving. My hand isn't, as you can probably see. There we go. That's better. Now we need to hook up the ground wire. For that, I'm going to bring the helping hand down here. I'm going to turn the light off. But I will make use of this to hold it still while I solder on it. So now, if I had one of these that would hold my hand still, I'd be very happy, but I'm pretty sure such a thing doesn't exist at the moment. So let's get this tacked down here. I am really excited about reaching the conclusion of this project because I really need a good bass. That little one, that short scale one that I built for my wife, is adequate, but it's not of the quality that I need for making recordings and that sort of thing. So I hate it when that happens. So I need something else, and I need the full size simply because I have big fingers. But let me rephrase that. I have long fingers. I have what my sister always called piano player's fingers. And Houston, we have a dead battery. Sorry about that. I had not noticed that my camera shut off. So while we were away, we got this one all soldered up. We got the white wire connected to the center pole, and we got the ground wire connected, and now we are moving on to the bridge pickup. I have looped the red wire over that center pole, and we're ready to start soldering. So again, sorry for the camera failure. This is probably going to feel like going back to kindergarten to some people, but I'm going to explain, just in case somebody doesn't know, how this works. These things here that I'm soldering to are called potentiometers, or POTS for short. And what it is a variable resistor. A resistor is a component that limits the flow of electricity. And the amount of resistance is measured in ohms after one of the pioneers of electrical research. And the more ohms, the more electricity it blocks. So this is a variable resistor. And what is happening here, the signal from the pickup is coming to the center pole called the wiper. That center pole moves when you turn the knob, and it moves toward one or the other of these. Now, there is a disc in there with a strip of carbon, and that carbon is the resistor. The wiper moves across it, and the further it goes on that strip, the more resistance there is. Turn it all the way to the end where the other wire is, and you have no resistance at all, and the signal goes on. But when you turn the resistance up, it blocks the signal. And so this is where the signal comes out. Now, it goes over here to this one because we want both controls to work independently. And so both of them are attached to what goes out to the over to the tone control, if I can spit it out. So that way each pickup has its own volume control, but they share the tone control. So that's a brief primer on how these things work. Now we will go ahead and fasten down our ground wire here on this one, and we should be ready to put the strings on. Oh, I cannot tell you what I am feeling right now about that, because my level of excitement is so off the charts, I'm having a hard time focusing on this. And we're good. I will use my multimeter to do some testing and make sure that we have solid connections everywhere. But from what I can see, all I need to do is put these things back in, and we should be ready for testing. Well, there it is. All the wires are put together, and the cover is on. Now, two major demerits for this company, because this cover didn't fit. I had to grind it down all around here to get it to fit. They sent me, I don't know if they sent me the wrong one or if somebody just cut it wrong, but yeah, this company just lost a couple of points in my book. However, everything checks out, so let's put some strings on. Okay. Here they are. Let's do this. Bass strings always fascinate me because they're just so huge. You may recall when I was putting strings on that little one, I had an awful time finding short scale strings. And regular strings were too fat for those tuners. So I had to do some special searching, and with these came with the instrument for starters. So that's one big advantage. We got some wobble in there that I'm not sure I like, but let's get it on there and see what we've got. What we've got is way too much string, so I'm gonna have to cut it. And now I went through all of my tools and stuff, reorganized everything, and I should have whatever I need right here handy. But the operative word there, as always, is should. Still, this should do it. So, or not. Wow. There's a nice gap in there. That is a useful tool. Let's try a different one. That's better. It's always good when a cutter cuts, isn't it? Alrighty. Now, we poke it in there. And we wind it up. Yeah. That kind of sounds vaguely risque, doesn't it? Oh well, not much I can do about it. So, I'm going to wish I had brought a winder. Because even with what I cut off, this string is ridiculously long. So, now one thing I have not done to this thing is adjust the truss rod. And I would hope the reasons for that are obvious. It doesn't have any tension on it yet. So, once we get these strings on it, I'll take a look at that and make whatever adjustments are necessary. I will try to be sure to film it. All right. One string on. There we go. All right, that's the high string. Let's go to the low one next. Just to try to keep pressure on even on both sides of the neck. So, he goes right there. And up over the saddle. Get the saddle to sit down. Get that out of the way. Good grief. Sometimes these things have a mind of their own. All right. There's low E. We'll clip that off a bit. And get it wound up. So. Yeah. Okay. That's the way it goes. Does not look right. For one thing, it's loose. So, I like to do these two outer ones first, as I said, to keep the tension fairly even on the two sides of the neck, especially since this is a brand new neck that hasn't had any tension on it before that we know of. So, I'm going to treat it as kindly as I can. So now, I don't know if you can see, but this is winding the wrong way. And I know I put these guys on properly. So that's something I guess I'll just have to put up with for now. I may look into it later on. Yeah, you can hear the buzzing. I'm going to have to adjust the saddle heights and the string heights, but that's all set up. We'll do that after we're done with this. And, well, actually, after we're done with most everything. So, the D string. I forgot, with these bridges, you have to kind of bend a little curve in the string. Because these interior strings, there's no room to get it over the saddle. So. Here we go with the D string. Yeah. Now, I have checked and double-checked the electronics in this thing. and everything should be working properly. But before I try to play it, I'm going to give it one more check. I'm going to open the back up and look at all the connections, test everything, and make sure it's ready. And make sure it's going to be putting out, you know, sound. So, I will do that off camera. And hopefully, after this, when we come back, she'll be ready to play. I have a real nice Ampeg amplifier that I'll show you when we get ready to do that. I'm quite pleased with it. It's a very nice amplifier. Has a really good sound. I can't decide if that string is in the wrong place. I think it might be. You know, with these two, it's impossible to tell. For the life of me, they look the same. Well, I'm not going to be able to tell until I get it on there. So, let's go ahead, install it, and then figure it out. Nope, that looks right. All right. Must have been an optical illusion of some kind. That was weird. So, So, we get this one put on, and then I'll do that final check that I was talking about. And we will see what we have. Okay, and here we are. Look what we have. I haven't tried to tune it, obviously, but here's our result. Okay, here's our result. Sorry for the wonky camera work here, but I think that is a gorgeous instrument. The only question now is, what does it sound like? We'll look at that next time. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you then.